Hi students and welcome back to the mathematics class. We are doing the chapter fraction. In the previous class we just understood the meaning of fraction and we also did some practice of the questions from the exercise. Now we are moving to the next part of the chapter, that is if we have any fraction, let the fraction be 3 by 4, 7 upon 8 and so on. Then how to show this fraction on the number line. So I hope you know the number line, that is if you start from the reference 0, we have 1 2 3 4 and so on one side, that is the numbers we have one side, another side we have -1 -2 -3 -4 and so on. So overall, if we have the fraction that is given to you and we have to show this particular number on this number line, then how to do it? So that is the very first thing we are going to understand, that is how to show the fraction on the number line. So that is the topic we have, the very first, that is fraction on the number line. So if you are given any line 0, 1, 2 and so on, so we are easily able to find out where is the whole numbers, the whole number on the number line 1, 2, 3, 4, -1, -2, that is the integers also, negative integers. So for the whole numbers or the negative integers, it's not a difficult task, easily we can find out. But if we are getting some number in the fraction, then we need to understand how to show this on the number line. So 1 by 3 is also a number, 3 by 4 is also a number. So these two numbers will also be somewhere on this number line, and that is what we have to find out. So that we need to understand how to locate the given fraction or the number in the form of fraction in the on the number line. So I hope you'll understand the concept. So very first, let's take one example to understand this properly. So let's take we have to show 1 by 3 on number line. So let's take this, the very first fraction we have 1 by 3, and that is to be shown on the number line. So very first thing, before we show it on the number line, we need to find out if this number given to you is between which two numbers. That is the very first thing we need to find out. So 1 by 3 in general, if you 1 by 3 if you are given, you know this is less than 1, because in this case your numerator is less than denominator. So all the time just remember, if your numerator is less than denominator, in that case this fraction will be less than 1. You can also check it. So if you divide 1 by 3, you know the decimal will come. So 3 3 is 9, again 3 3 is 9, and this will go on. So overall what we are getting, 0.33, and this 0.33 is less than 1. So we understood here 0.33 is less than 1. It means 1 by 3 is less than 1, but it is greater than 0 also. So that is understood here, 0.33 is somewhere between 0 and 1. So that is the very first thing to be calculated or to analyze, that is the given fraction is between which two numbers. So you understood 0.33 is between 0 and 1. Okay, but where it is, that now we have to show. So very first, what is to be done? Make the number line. Okay, so make the number line and write on one side 0 and one side 1. Okay, but now what you see, so let it be 1 here. So this is 0, this is 1, and now 1 by 3 will be somewhere in between this 0 and 1. So what is to be done next? After this, we have to find out total how many parts we have. So you can see here, overall in denominator we have 3, in numerator we have 1. So we can understand this, overall there are 3 equal parts. So after you found that the number is between 0 and 1, now this entire has to be divided into how many parts? 3 equal parts. So now just divide this in 3 equal parts. So beta, if you take the help of the scale properly, for example this is 1, 2 and 3, so it will go somewhere other side. So division should be equal. Try. Okay, so now this is your 1, 2, 3 equal parts. You are able to see, I hope. So what we did very first, we found out if this fraction is less than 1. Yes. Now where it is between 0 and 1, we understood. Now what is to be done? Between 0 and 1 we should have equal number of divisions, so that we get from the denominator. So that is divided into 3 equal parts, 1, 2, 3. And now this is nothing but the first part of 3. So out of 3, 1, 2, 3, this is 1/3 of the total. This is 2/3 of the total. And this is nothing but overall 3/3 of the total, that is nothing but 1 only. So 3 by 3 can be written as 1. So that's why we don't need to write out this one. So I hope you understood. First we found if the given fraction is between which two numbers, so 0 and 1. Now we have to see how many equal parts to be made. So 3 we divided into 3 equal parts, and now each part is written as it is. So 1 by 3, this is the first part, 2 by 3, this is the second part, and totally 3 by 3. So this is 1 upon 3 total. Okay, this is 2 upon 3 and this is 3 upon 3. So I hope you understood. From here to here it is showing the very first part, from here to here it is showing you the second part, and this is showing you the total 3 parts. So this is your 1 by 3, this is your 2 upon 3, and this is your 3 upon 3, that is also equal to 1. So finally this is our location. So at last you can circle it to show that this is the location for 1 upon 3. So I hope you understood this one. Let's take one more example, they will have more clarity. Okay, so 1 by 3 we have done. Now let's go for 3 upon 5 or number line. So let's try this one. So 3 by 5 is to be shown on the number line. Again we need to find out 3 by 5 is between which two number. So again you see 3 upon 5, your n is 3, your denominator is 5, again your n is less than d, so 3 by 5 must be less than 1. So no need to check it again and again by dividing, but even if you divide you will get the answer in decimal. So you understood, this number is also between 0 and 1, because 3 by 5 will be more than 0 but will be less than 1. So again we have to do the same thing. Make the number line. One side we have 0, one side we should have 1. This is the first thing. And now overall how many parts we should have? 5. So again you see the denominator, that is your d is 5. So total 5 equal parts we have to make on this line from 0 to 1. So again you make 5 equal parts. So you better take the help of the scale to make equal part, that will be always better option. So let me make the parts equal. 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So let the 1 be here and 0 is here. So I have taken the equal gap, that is 2 inch. So that is to be taken care. So now you understood, this is 0 to 1, 5 equal parts. So this is the very first part of the total parts. So this is your 1/5 of the total. Now this is your 2/5, this is your 2/5 of the total. This is your 3/5 of the total, and this is your 4/5 of the total. Again, this should be your 5/5, so that will become 1. No need to show. So what we have to show? 3/5. So where is 3/5? This is your 3/5. So 3/5 is expressed on this number line. So I hope you understood the simple method how to show the fraction on the number line. Now let's go for the next concept we have. That is types of fraction that we need to understand also. Okay, so let's go one by one. So very first, let's take the example to understand what are the different types of the fraction. So I'm writing the very first 3 upon 4, 7 upon 9, 2 upon 5. There are 3 examples I've written to you. In all the 3, what is the similarity you see? That is your n. For take the very first example, 3/4. So for this, n is how much? 3, and t is how much? 4. N for numerator, d for denominator. Here we have numerator 7 and denominator 9, and here we have numerator 2, denominator 5. So if you see all the 3 fractions which are shown to you, in all the 3 cases there is one similarity, and that is in all the 3 cases your numerator is less than the denominator. So 3 is less than 4, 7 is less than 9, 2 is less than 5. Such fractions where your numerator is basically less than denominator, we called it proper fraction. So this is your very first called proper fraction. Okay, so all these examples are of proper fraction. That is, the numerator is less than denominator. So briefly you should know this is the meaning. Okay, so all these examples are nothing but showing the parts of the whole. So the 4 equal parts, out of 4 equal parts, 3 are the parts which are shown to you. So that is the simple meaning you should have. In any fraction, if you see the numerator is coming less than your denominator, it is called proper fraction. So till now, whatever we have understood, whatever examples we have seen, that all were proper fraction. So I hope you understood. Now let's go for second one. That is number 2. So I'm writing another example. Okay, so I'm writing 4 upon 3, 7 upon 4, 9 upon 6. Not 6, let's write on 2. Okay, now these are also fractions and these are also possible. I'll show you. So being first, in this case your numerator is 4 and your denominator is 3. In this case your numerator is 7, denominator is 4. In this case numerator is 9 and denominator is 2. Now again, what you see, the similarity we have between the 3, that is here in all the 3 cases your numerator is coming greater than denominator. So 4 is greater than 3, 7 is greater than 4, 9 is greater than 2. Such fractions where numerator is coming greater than denominator, or even if I write 3 upon 3, that is both numerator and denominator are equal, that is, or numerator and denominator are equal, then these are of different category of the fraction, that is called improper fraction. So we can say, if we have this condition, that is numerator is greater than denominator, or if they are equal also, that is the last case. In both the case, what we have improper fraction. So we can say the numerator is greater than or equal टू डिनोमिनेटर. So that is the condition you can remember for a proper fraction. And let's understand in which case these things are possible. Okay. So now let's see in which case that improper fraction is possible. So just take an example. You are given three apples. So let me make a rough diagram. So this is first apple, second apple. Given to you, and this is your third apple. Okay, so you are given first apple, second apple, third apple. Out of three, you ate this completely, you ate this also completely, but here you are able to eat only half, so only 1/2 you are able to eat. So if you divide the apple in two equal parts, out of two you are able to eat only one part, so that is 1/2. So overall, how many apples you ate? So how to show it? So first thing you understood here properly, that is you ate how many apples? 1 + 1 + 1/2. So you ate only half. So show only half here. Okay, so this can be written as 2 + 1/2, means 2.5. So how many apples you ate? 2.5 apples, and that can be shown in the form of a fraction also. So let's understand how to show this 2.5 in the form of a single fraction number. So let's understand. So I hope you understood the case. 2.5 apples you ate, that is 1 + 1 + 1/2. So you are getting 2 + 1/2. So finally you are getting 2 + 1/2. In the coming classes we will see if we understood the meaning of fraction, then how to add the numbers which are in the fraction form. So that is not done now. So briefly you should know what is to be done. I will be writing this denominator as it is. Why we will see later on. Okay. And then multiply 2 and 2. So 2 into 2 is how much? 4. And then add the number which is next to the plus sign. So 1 is there. So we just multiply 2 and 2 and added 1. So this will be 2 into 2, 4 plus 1/2. This is 5/2. So basically the meaning is your 2 + 1/2 is nothing but equal to 5/2. So either you say that you ate 2.5 apples, or you say you ate 5/2 apples, they are same thing. So overall 2 + 1/2 is equivalent, is equal to 5/2, which is again you can see numerator is your greater than denominator, because 5 is greater than 2. So this is one of the improper fraction, and the meaning you understood, I hope, the meaning of improper fraction, which is somewhere showing you the fractions of which is a combination of a whole number plus some fraction which is a part of the whole only. Okay, so I hope this part is clear. So the possibility that we have, so if I say you are given 1, 2, 3 and half, so this is your 1, 1, 1, and you are getting half squares, for example, then how many squares you have? So you know 1 + 1 + 1 = 3 + 1/2. So we can say we have 3.5 squares, or we can say 3 × 2 + 1/2, that is 6 + 1/2, that is 7/2. So this can be shown by this 3 + 1/2, that is 3.5. Or we can convert into a single fraction, that is not is coming 7/2, which is showing you the same thing. 7/2 squares we have, simple. So I hope you understood the meaning of proper, improper, and the next we have, that is mixed fraction, the last one. Okay, so this is your third type of the fraction, which is mixed one, mixed fraction. So let's start writing the same thing again, 2 plus 1 by 2, that we understood. So overall, this can be written also as like 2 can be written here and 1 by 2 can be written here. Okay. So without plus sign, we can show it in the single number, in the form of single number. And now whatever you are able to see is nothing but your mixed fraction. So here 2 upon 1 by 2 is equivalent to 2 plus 1 by 2. So 2 plus 1 by 2 and 2 1 by 2, they are same thing. So here we can say overall how many numbers you are able to see. You are able to see 2, which is a whole number. That is coming from here, that is a whole number. You are able to see 1 by 2, which is nothing but proper fraction, 1 is less than 2. So, the number which is shown to you, 2 upon 1 by 2, is made up of two things. One is a whole number and second is a proper fraction. Whenever we are getting such number, is basically called mixed fraction. So, I hope you understood. And that is coming somewhere from improper fraction only. So improper can be converted into mixed fraction. We'll see, understand also, not to worry. So if I'm writing 3 plus 1 by 7, this can also be written as 3 1 upon 7. So this is again your mixed fraction. Okay, so overall one fraction or improper fraction can be converted into mixed fraction, and mixed can also be converted into improper. That is the word. What is the next thing that we have going to learn? How to convert the... Okay, so we can say a fraction having a whole number and proper fraction is mixed fraction. So I hope you understood properly. So examples we understood: 3, 1 upon 4, 7, 2 upon 5, and so on. These are your mixed fraction, where your first number is a whole number, and the next one is a ratio. What is the fraction? That is 1 by 4, 2 by 5, which are nothing but your proper fraction. So now let's see how to convert. So convert mixed fraction into improper fraction. So we'll understand both the things one by one. If the mixed fraction is given to you, how to convert it into improper. If improper is given, how to convert into mixed. So let's start with the very first thing. So again, let's take the example. So let's say I'm giving you 3, 1 upon 7. And 3, 1 upon 7 is a mixed fraction, and we have to convert into improper fraction. So the step is very simple. You will multiply the numerator with the whole number. So the whole number is 3, you multiply the denominator with the whole number. So 3 into 7, that is how much? 21. And then the numerator which is given to you should be added. So add 1 with the same number. That is after multiplication, whatever you are getting. This is 22. So now the new number is 22. That is the new numerator we have is 22. Denominator will remain 7. So this is nothing but your improper fraction. You can see your numerator is greater than denominator. So both are same number. So whether you say 3 1 by 7, or you can say 22 upon 7, they are same thing. The only thing is we are able to express in a different way. Let's take another example. 4, 9 upon 5. So 4, 9 upon 5, mixed fraction is given to you, convert into improper. So again, denominator and whole number will be multiplied. So here 4 will be multiplied with 5, that is how much? 20. And with the same, we will add the numerator, that is 9 will be added here. So 29. So our new numerator is 29, denominator will remain 5. So very simple steps we have to convert the mixed into improper fraction. I hope you understood. And now let's take just the opposite case. That is, now we are given the improper fraction and convert into mixed. So convert improper fraction into mixed fraction. Okay, so let's understand with the example the steps properly. So you are given 20/7. Okay, so this is one of the mixed improper fraction, because 20 is greater than 7. What is to be done? Very first, you divide the numerator with or by denominator. So we have to divide 20/7. Okay, so in two times only we can divide, and remainder will get how much? 6. All of you understood? We divided 20/7. In two times only we can divide, and remainder is coming how much? So here we have remainder as 6. Now what is to be done? Now we cannot proceed because we don't have to take the decimal case. After remainder, if we cannot divide further, just stop there. And now we have to convert. So what is to be done? Very first, the denominator will be written as it is. 7 will be written 7 only. Now, in how many times we divided? 2 times. So this 2 is a whole number we are getting now. So that will come here in front. And how much remainder we are getting? 6. That will come at the top. So this is the new number, new fraction, which is a mixed one. So 20/7 and 6/7, they are same thing. So this is our answer. 6/7. Okay, let's take another example, number 2, that is 15/4. Let's take example. So again, 15/4 is improper fraction, because 15 is greater than 4, and how to convert into mixed fraction. So again, we'll do the same thing. 15 will be divided by 4. In how many times? 3 times only we can divide. Remainder is 3. I hope you understood. So here we have 4. So denominator will remain as it is. How many times we divide it? 3 times. That 3 will come here. That is the whole number. And how much is the remainder here? 3 only. So that will come at the top. So that is how we can convert the improper fraction into mixed fraction. We need to divide, find the remainder, and then just show it this way. Simple. Now, since you have understood the concepts, let's take some questions from the exercise from NCERT 7.2, and then rest you can try yourself at home. So very first question is to locate on number line. So different examples are given, questions are given. I'll do the B part here. 1/8, 2/8, 3/8, 7/8, 2/8, 3/8, and 7/8. So the question is, we have to locate these fractions on the number line. So very first, you can see here it is 1/8, which is your less than 1, 7/8 is less than 1. So overall, all these numbers 2/8, 3/8 are less than 1 but greater than 0. So all these numbers are between 0 to 1. This is understood now. Okay, and now between 0 and 1, how many equal parts we should have? That is, we have to see the denominator here, that is 8. So overall 0 to 1 should be divided into 8 equal parts. So let's start this way. So you can start properly. You can start with number line. Okay, and let's divide it. So division should be equal. So this is, I'm taking 4 parts. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 4 more. So what I read, this is your 0, this is your 1, and 0 and 1 is divided into how many equal parts? 8 equal parts. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So you understood, this one is your 1 part of total parts. So this is your 1 of total parts. Total parts 8. This is how 1 plus 1, 2, 2 of total parts. This is 3 of total parts, 4 of total parts, 5 of total parts, 6 of total parts, 7 of total parts, 8 of 8 parts. That is your 1. So 1 by 8, 2 by 8, 3 by 8, 4 by 8, 5 by 8, 6 by 8, 7 by 8, and 8 by 8. I hope. Now what is to be shown? 1 by 8. So 1 by 8 is here. You can circle it. 2 by 8 is here next to this only. 3 by 8 is next to this. And 7 by 8 is where? This one. So we understood. So I hope you understood how to show or locate the fraction on the number line. So rest you can try yourself. And I'm going for the next question. That is, we have number 2. That is, the question is, convert into mixed fraction. So convert into mixed fraction. So whatever fraction is given to you, we have to convert that into mixed fraction. So the question I'm taking here is B, 11 by 5. So 11 by 5 is given to you, and I'll take one more. Let's take 19 by 6. That is question number E. So I'll take this two. Rest you try yourself. So we know what is to be done. Again, we'll divide 11 by 5. So divide 11 by 5 in two times. You'll divide. Remainder will be how much? 1. So what is to be done? We know 5 will be written as it is. In how many times? 2 times. What is the remainder? 1. Answer done. Again, let's divide 19 by 6. So you'll divide 19 by 6. In how many times? 3 times. 6 is 18. Remainder is how much? Again, 1. So what is to be written? Denominator as it is. How many times? 3 times. How much is the remainder? 1. Answer is 3, 1 upon 6. So I hope you understood. It's very simple. So rest you can try yourself. I'll go for question number 3 now. I'll take 1 or 2 parts and rest you try yourself. Convert into improper. So convert into improper fractions. So now mixed fraction is given to you. 7, 3 upon 4. And let me take one more. D. 10, 3 upon 5. Okay, so these two are given to you. And we have to convert them into improper fraction. So we know what is to be done. We'll multiply the whole number with the denominator. So we'll multiply 7 with 4. 7 with 4. How much? 28. And then numerator will be added here. That is how much? Plus 3. That is how much? 31. So now our new numerator is 31 and denominator will remain 4. So this is the answer. 31 upon 4. Again, 10 will be multiplied with 5. That is how much? 50. And 3 will be added here because numerator is 3. So add the 3. That is how much? 53. So our new numerator is 53. Denominator will remain 5. Done. So I hope you understood the class and understood the meaning of proper, improper and mixed fraction, and the meaning also properly. And you have seen the examples, how to convert one into the other and how to locate the fraction on the number line. So rest you practice yourself from the NCERT exercise. Whatever things are not done by me from this exercise 7.2, try it yourself at home. So for today is done. Just take care, be at home. Thank you and Hari Om.